Hey y'all, welcome back. Today we're talking about career planning and scrapbooking. I'm gonna show you guys how I try to plan like certain areas of my life through scrapbooking. So stay tuned, it's story time. Well, I just recently started scrapbooking when 2018 started and I was like, oh, let me create a scrapbook for like goals for the future and all those things that like you kind of keep in the back of your mind and you have an idea of how you want it to look, but you don't necessarily like have a plan on paper. So scrapbooking became like my blueprint, if you will, for life. So I can clip out things that I like or goals and write them in. It just really helps me stay organized with what I want out of life. When you're scrapbooking, like the first thing you have to figure out is how you want to do it. You have to pick a book or a poster board or something large or with a lot of pages so you can get like a full scrapbooking experience out of it. I chose this book. It's a sketchbook, and so in a sketchbook it has like lots of empty pages for you to use and for you to paste stuff to, draw on, even write if you wanted to. So you get a lot of options when you grab a sketchbook. So I do recommend this. I actually got this from Target, I think. Oh no, I got this from Five Below. I got this from Five Below, so it was like $5. Because it was an opening, but it was like $5. So you could go and grab a sketchbook from Five Below or Target or Walmart or Hobby Lobby or Michaels, like anywhere. You just want a scrapbook that has like a lot of empty pages for you to work with. And I'll show you guys what I put in my scrapbook in a minute. The next thing you need to do is get magazines. You got to have magazines. If you don't have like a subscription to magazines, then you want to just ask people for their magazines. Like everybody always has like a house full of magazines. So it's nothing for you to take them off someone's hands instead of them having to figure out like how to recycle them. And I actually had my sister like go to work and I was like, ask people for their magazines, because I didn't have any after I moved. So you can get like household magazines, like This Old House. You can get 17 magazines. So you get like the cute girly kind of pages. And then you can like clip out the stuff like the cherry or the smiley face. And you get to work with that. I have Uptown, so you can get People of Color. You can get any kind of magazine, really, because what you're looking for is like the fonts that are in the magazine. You want to look at the pictures. Teen Vogue, you can, if you like in the fashion or you just like the really cool fonts that you can find in here, that's what you're looking for. You're looking for magazines that have like an eye-catching cover, or you know, like in the pages they'll actually have like different fonts and different pictures of not only like people dressed up but also like items and things like that. So like, see, if I wanted to cut out the weights and say I wanted to start exercising more, or I wanted to ride a bike, which y'all know I can't do, so I could cut that out too. And then like if I wanted to start trying new hair products or something like that. So there are all kinds of ways for you to like play around. Oh, they actually got some. Look at Zendaya, hold up. Y'all see I haven't cut out this one yet. Goals in life. A library in my house. I want that. So this is cool. So yeah, you just want to grab different magazines. If you're a guy, Sports Illustrated, hello. You can go through and pick out, see if you wanted to be a boxer. You could take out Floyd Mayweather and put that in a corner. Yeah, ooh, Jesus. If you wanted to look good in a suit, if you wanted a custom tailored suit, you could cut that out, put that in there. They've got some cool lettering in here. So there's like tons of things for you to do in even in fashion. Look, you can even find fashion in Sports Illustrated. So you just want to find magazines that you can actually find something in. Like, I hate flipping through. I wouldn't recommend like the Ulta magazines and stuff like that. Those, they're not that helpful. I didn't like them because like there were sometimes there were good lettering, like the typography in it was well done, but like you didn't get a variety of words. So it was like shop now, unlimited, like words like that that you can't necessarily use for anything. So use magazines that use a lot of color or they have like a lot of ads in them. So like this one is for Bob's, I don't even know, Skechers. Yes, this is for Skechers, the shoes. This is for Skechers, but you can also clip out like the front of this car and use it for traveling. So collect them, get them, ask people for their magazines, maybe other newsletters and stuff like that that they don't want anymore. Collect them up, store them. I got mine on a bookshelf, so I could just walk over and grab another one if I need it. Definitely try to just collect as many magazines as you can from other people and get them to give them to you for free instead of having to go to the store and buy all those magazines. So that's the first thing, you know. After you get your sketchbook, you need to get magazines. Like sometimes even like find them in the recycling bin if it's clean. Don't go in it if it's dirty. I won't suggest that. But then looking at my sketchbook, so I've only been doing it for like 3 months, so I don't have a ton of pages filled out, and I like to put like a lot of detail in my scrapbook. So now I'm just gonna walk you guys through how I do that, and hopefully it'll give you ideas about how you can do your own sketchbook. So here we go. Okay guys, so here is my sketchbook. I started out with the end of 2017 and then added some things that I felt like fit into how my 2017 went. I felt like love was a good thing in 2017, like I had healthy intimate relationships with people, and I think that's incredible. I love Maya Angelou, y'all know. So bold and trendy is what I felt like I was embracing in 2017. And social media, of course, like I picked up more social media habits in 2017 and actually started building a brand out of that. And quotes, a couple quotes that helped me out and described my 2017 experience. And then this one, I love this one. Stop waiting for blank to make you happy. You're in charge. That's just a great reminder for anybody who's ever like stalled or been hesitant to like embrace who they are as a person. Like that's one of the greatest gifts you could ever have. And I feel like 2017 was like the final touch on me becoming who I am and me loving that. So that was 2017. Now we're crossing into 2018. There are tons of things that I started adding. You don't have to have like completely filled pages like I do, but it is helpful to like try to get a good range of things on your scrapbook so that you can like come back to it and be like, oh, why did I pick out these glasses? Well, I like entertaining and I like having people over and being hospitable, so I really like this color too. It reminds me of spring, so it reminds me to like be engaging, be open to having people around and people in your life, and that's great. Having a drink every night, or that was a cute little thing I pulled out about having a glass of wine every day. I've got curves ahead and a little full-figured woman. Because it's just embracing like your body type and your style and your way of being in the world and not trying to conform to what dominant culture tells you is beautiful, you know? So I even took off her head because I was like, I don't even want to have to envision who she is in embracing who I am, you know? It's not a comparison. It's not, you'd be cuter if da 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 da. Like, if you're healthy, embrace who you are and what you look like. And then happiness, when it rains, it pours, instead of it being like a sad thing, like, oh, my life is so tragic, so many bad things are happening, but like happiness is raining, and when it rains, it pours. So even doing like different quotes that bring tension into like how we normally understand things has been like really cool while I'm scrapbooking, because you'll find so many magazines that have these cliches or quotes and things like that, and then you could just use them to talk about whatever you want to talk about instead of using them the way they were created. Definitely want to travel. Italy is on my list. Y'all, I want to go to Italy so bad. Like, I always look at the Groupon tickets. I'm always looking at how expensive it is to fly over there, and I'm always looking at one-way tickets. Hello. Like, if I get to Italy, I might not come back, and that's probably why I haven't gone yet. God is afraid he's gonna lose me, but it's okay.
redefine my everyday. So finding what's your normal, you know, your black girl magic, of course, holler. I love flashy jewelry. I'm really gaudy. Glamour, smart, simple. This side gets into more of a like empowerment side. So take care of sexy. You want a vacation, you want to be fit. The vacation in Paris, y'all saw that. I liked her style a lot. She had on like a sweater with a little lace under skirt, and then her heels, and I really like that. I say if you got it, flaunt it, you know, fear of nothing. I loved how I clipped that together. It looks like it could have been together, I don't know. But don't be afraid to like take things apart and put them together in different ways. And this, you could tell, is the beginning of January, because on my birthday, I was turning 28. So this is what I was hoping 28 would look like. I wanted to be filled with hope. Look at this, a little passion up there, okay. Next up is women. Oh, look, this one is about like family, focusing on building a family. So I've got a baby up here, because one day I'm gonna have a baby, and a house that I liked, and another house that I liked. I'm really into Italian architecture, which is why I really want to go to Italy. So I have these two houses that kind of favor that Italian family style. And then throw in some Chanel, because y'all know I love my Chance perfume. Yes, Lord. And in the spirit, just letting who you are as a woman culminate itself, like just come together so beautifully. I like these coats. I think that's what my Olivia Pope, right? I was trying to get my Olivia Pope on, honey, like business, get it together. So having it all, having like the house and the family and then successful career, all of that at once, and then just living in your spirit. Then over here, this is like more of a wedding kind of vibe. Just pulling out different kinds of stuff. Yeah, let me see what's cool over here. Just some like fun quotes about stuff. Love Jones, of course. You see the bride. Her white dress was cute. I didn't find a wedding dress, but I just found a bride magazine. So now I can probably do another page about that. Inside of a kitchen. Yeah, so that one's just married life inspo. This one is more womanhood, more embodiment. So feel beautiful, liberated woman, entertain, because again, I like having people over. So there's some cheese trays and stuff up under there. And then I really want to do a TED talk. I want to be on a TED talk so bad. And I'm writing out the script for when I actually get invited to do a TED talk. I know, I'm preparing. Preparation is everything. So I thought this was really cool, and I had to add it because I'm all about storytelling and rewriting your own personal narrative. So that's on there, of course. Sisters, like again, with women, bringing women together. Sister, it was amazing to realize I wasn't alone. Like, I have four sisters, and they're really special to me. So I think like having a sisterhood that even reaches outside of your blood, right? So I have so many women in my life who I consider to be very close to me and like sisters. So this page is kind of for that. Bold always wins. I don't crack under pressure. I thrive on it. I love Tracee Ellis Ross. So I love her curls too. So she had to be on there. And then I don't even know what this one was. I don't know. But Rihanna, I love Rihanna. Maybe I had to have balance or something. So I threw Idris Elba on there. But yeah, treat yourself all the time. Every week. Do something to treat yourself. What's this one? Okay, so health and body was the theme of this one. And I was focused on really taking care of myself as a human. You know, I love drinking tea. So it was really important to put like a teapot up there. I love her. Oh, I got so many people in here I love. But just embodying who I am and then also taking care of the body I inhabit is really important. So self-care, helping me stay mentally and emotionally and spiritually in tune and healthy is my primary goal in 2018. And it took a rocky beginning, but I'm figuring it out, y'all. we all have the power to heal, is what Viola Davis said. And so this page is about beginning that healing process. And then a major part of that is like what goes on around us, right? So Solange knows, y'all, don't touch my hair, Cranes in the Sky, love it, wrote my thesis about her album. I'll share it if you want to read it. And then of course Stay Woke, this was on the cover of a magazine, and I only clipped out a few of them, but they're all placed with like throughout my scrapbook. And just Black power, y'all. Black power. It's more than just curls. It's a reminder of my identity and my roots. As you can see, now we're getting into the section where I'm still building it out. This is the beginning of my professional goals page. And so I was talking to you guys about how to do career planning with your scrapbook, and here's where it starts. This page, I think I'm going to dedicate to some of my favorite activists. And because I don't think I'll find pictures for all of them, I'm just going to write in names too. That's why I left this bottom page open. And then on this side, y'all remember her from General Hospital, I think? I love her. She was the best. This page is, again, going towards like professionalism and just seeking out success, but also seeking out your calling. So again, it'll be like collaborative with women and other things like that. So I'm still building it out, but I wanted to give you guys a snapshot of how you can actually organize your career or your goals using scrapbooking. I think it's so helpful because you just get to combine all these different pieces and they each tell their story, you know? Like somebody will ask, well, why'd you cut out that picture instead of another picture? Why is that word so powerful to you? And you can tell them. You can tell them. You can start rewriting your narrative. So that's how I do my scrapbook, and I look forward to continuing it.
So thank you guys for tuning in. I've really loved sketchbooking so far in 2018, and it'll probably be something that I try to continue to do and make time for. You know, I told you guys in the post that I usually do scrapbooking while I'm watching TV, so it's like multitasking instead of actually having to like cut out separate time in my schedule to scrapbook. So if I'm doing it while I'm watching TV, it's probably a show that I can like listen to without really having to pay close attention to. So any kind of reality TV, the news, anything like that. Not during This Is Us. If I'm watching This Is Us, I cannot scrapbook. But yeah, that's how I usually find time to scrapbook. If you can't find time in your schedule to actually like cut out everything and then paste it in your book, maybe you want to just have a cutting day, right? Where you spend like 2 hours that day just cutting out of all the magazines and then put them in a Ziploc bag. And then on another day, you can paste them, you know, and find how you want them stationed on your pages. Maybe even have Ziploc bags for each theme. So if it's my home and cleaning Ziploc bag for things that pertain to household needs, then I can do my household page. If I have one for fashion, I can do my fashion one day. If I have like travel or makeup and stuff like that, then I can have a different Ziploc bag for each one. And then that's a way where you don't have to necessarily sit down and flip through every page and then take time to actually paste it in your sketchbook. Like, it's supposed to be something that's like therapeutic and fun for you to do, and not something that you feel like is a hassle to do. So try it out. I hope you enjoyed looking at my scrapbook. I'll try to check in again maybe in like 4 more months and show you guys how I've updated my scrapbook. And hopefully you can take advantage of scrapbooking too. Thanks for tuning in today. Take care, y'all. Hey y'all, this series is just the beginning. Every week I'll release new videos that help us approach spiritual and lifestyle changes that we want to make to become healthier and more positive human beings. So meet me back here every Sunday at 7 p.m. for new videos, and we'll continue writing our stories together. Take care, y'all.